man, if I wasn't on a diet, oh, I'd get me a Big Mac and a double quarter pounder with cheese, fries, nuggets, maybe like 20 of those, and a large Diet Coke. Oh man, if I wasn't so fat, I would be eating a Big Mac right now. I would be savoring that first bite while staring at the half-spilled box of fries, trying to pick out the one I'm going to eat first. But alas, I am too much of a fat man, so I will have to go without McDonald's. Kids too, they're just making me look bad. Well, not so much that one. All right, so we're at Nomad's dirt bike track. Talk about a few questions I got in an email about the KTM that I'd like to answer. I gotta start off first by letting everybody know that, you know, if you haven't watched all my videos, or you might have missed, that I am not by any means an expert or skilled rider. I'm very new at this. I rode when I was a teenager a few times. So these little kids are over here bombing around the track. They're killing it, making me feel like a little girl. I shouldn't say that. One of them might be a little girl. Anyways, I'm by no means an expert, and I've only had the bike for about 2 months now. I do not take it out to the track. This is only the second time it's been out here. And as I was saying, it's only the second time I've been out here. So I don't know how much influence over any decision making I have. Somebody's asking me about whether they should buy a 350 or 500 if they want to upgrade. And I really don't know. I mean, I can only tell you from my point of view, and my point of view, like I said, is a lot of limited experience. So start off with one of the first questions he asked me, I think, or one of the questions that he asked was about the maintenance schedule on the bike. And yes, it does have a rough maintenance schedule. First maintenance is supposed to take place at 1 hour, which you could burn an hour just test driving after you get home. After the 1 hour maintenance, then just down to, that's every 15 hours. As far as the things you need to do, I probably shouldn't be doing this video on the track. I can't focus on what I'm doing. That was a little rough. And then it's always 15 hours. Always 15 hours. There's a long laundry list of things that have to be done, actually. All I've done so far is oil changes. Um,
mods. There's the handguards, the Sycra Pro Bands that I put on, which I've already done a review, and maybe I'll put a link up here somewhere. And then I have this TMD coincidentally, today, when I first came out here, I was warming up. I didn't have the cameras on. I cased on one of these jumps. He yanked the skid plate back off the frame, ran it into my back tire, which took a little while to fix. Not a long time. Took me about maybe 10 minutes or so to get it back on. As the bike goes, it's a little heavy, but I needed it heavy. When I bought the bike, I weighed about 220 pounds, a little even more. That's without my gear on. Compared to the Honda, it's a feather. And I'm much better on it than I was on the Honda. Like, that would have sent me down on the Honda. It's got a ton of power, where you need it, when you need it. It's just, it's a lot of fun to ride. When I was reading the reviews on it, a lot of them said, if you want to do a lot of single track and stuff, the 350 is the better bike. And I don't know exactly why, probably because it's light. So let's take a look at this thing on some single track. And I mean, I'm sure somebody else can probably ride it better than I do. I'm not, again, not the greatest rider. I wouldn't even say I'm good. I'm fair at best. So through this single track, bike suddenly feels heavy. Like, through everything else that I ride, the bike feels light and manageable. But once we get into the single track, I can feel how heavy it is. First time today. This first time in a couple weeks. So again, I can feel it getting heavy.
The other problem is it's pretty tall. And being a short guy, I'm 5'9½, maybe a little bit more. I can't reach the ground flat-footed. And that's really tough in these little sketchy places where there's not a lot of room to maneuver around. Or when you need to put your feet down and help yourself along. The single track is a little rough on me. I'm sure a more experienced or better rider would give you a better review or a different review. But from my point of view as a beginner, still learning, single track's pretty tough. So I'd have to keep working at it and you know, get better at it before I could really give you an honest review on that. Again, the bike has plenty of power for whatever it is you plan on doing. As far as motocross, again, another thing I'm not very good at, I'm still learning. What I need to learn to do is how to turn without washing out, without losing it. Although I turn a lot better on this bike than the Honda, I still have a lot of room for improvement. These are all things we got to take into consideration. I am not, again, I'm not a good rider. I'm mediocre, I'm just learning. And that really is what my video series was kind of supposed to be about. It's just gotten a little off track. For guys like me who are just, you know, going through some midlife crisis or whatever, I want to get out there and do something fun, live on the edge just a little bit. I love the bike. I wouldn't trade it for anything. If I was going to suggest to anybody, if the road's not that important, you know, you're not worried about, you know, going fast, and I don't even know how fast the 350 is. It might be really fast on the road. I got this thing up to about 90. 350 again, it might be just as fast, I don't know, but wherever you can save weight, I think it's a good thing, unless you're a big heavy guy, you know. So I weighed 220 when I bought the bike, and I was concerned that if I was actually gonna get the 350. I was concerned though that if I went 350 that I would regret it later once I got good at riding the bike. I mean, that's what happened with the Honda. I got good at riding the Honda. At some point, I got better at riding than what the Honda was capable of doing. I mean, I'm sure the Honda could have taken me a little farther, but I could feel it. I was getting to the point where I wanted something more powerful. So if you think that you're gonna grow out of that bike, I mean, probably what, $10,000 bike? That's a lot of investment for something that you're not gonna wanna hang on to. I would suggest the 500. It's because you're not going to grow out of it. If you're looking at getting a KTM 350 or 500, I don't think you can go wrong. Do it now. I know everybody's worried about the maintenance schedule, and you know, that's nothing to just balk at, but I wouldn't let that be the determining factor.